Transmutator by JMG Sound is a plugin to create morphing between tracks. Why would you need a plugin to create these blends? Well, Transmutator does blends, morphs and crossfades through a wide variety of effects. For instance, like this. Or like this. In this video, I will show you why this plugin is a little gem. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. I read the manuals so you don't have to. The plugin is really basic. But before you do anything, you'll need to set up the sidechain for this plugin to be able to create the blends. Enable sidechain, choose the track to be used in the sidechain, set the sidechain to pre-fader to make sure the original audio of the track doesn't play as well by turning down the fader of that track. The send is pre-fader, so the audio of the sidechain sent track will play in the plugin. I have aligned these two tracks and we're good to go. The controls. A is the audio of the track the plugin is on and B is the sidechain of the audio of the other track of the blend. The dry wet slider works by going up and down, not sideways. Maybe they can change that behavior in an update. It reduces the power of the effect and when it's completely set to dry, it will behave as a normal volume crossfade. Here's the gain control for the audio of the A part, and this is the gain for the sidechain audio feed of B. With the output gain, you can compensate the overall output volume. With these dials here, you can select between the 16 blend modes, which I will let you hear in a second. The invert dial will invert the behavior of the blend mode, and this is totally dependent of the mode used. The interface is resizable, which is always a plus, and every parameter is automatable. And now back to the all important part of this plugin, the blend modes. You can select from 16 modes. First up is filter. Filter is a high pass filter, which is applied to A, and a low pass, which is applied to B. When you turn up the blend, the frequency of both filters will increase from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. This will make it sound like the blend is moving upwards. And if you select invert and then turn up the dial, then it will sound like the blend is moving downwards. Spectrum uses spectral processing to separate the tonal and noise elements from the inputs. From 0 to 50%, the noise from A is crossfaded with the noise from B, so when you add 50%, you will hear the tone of A and the noise from B. From 50 to 100%, the tone from A is crossfaded with the tone from B, so the noise is blended first and then the tone. And if you use inverted, then the tone will be blended first and then the noise. Morph. Morph uses a spectral algorithm to blend the inputs. And it sounds like this. With invert, it will sound completely different. Stereo is also very interesting because it blends the mid and side parts of the audio. From 0 to 50, it first blends the mid signals of A and B. And from 50 to 100%, it blends the sides of both signals. If you choose invert, it will first blend the sides and then the mid. Pan uses panning to blend both audio tracks. If you turn the blend dial up, it first will blend the left from A with the left from B. And from halfway up, it will start to blend the right channels of both audio tracks. By inverting, it will be, of course, be the opposite. The transients splits the inputs into their transient and tail components. So first it will blend the tail from A with the tail from B, and from 50% and up it will blend the transients of both audio tracks. Invert once again does the exact opposite. It will first start with transients and then the tail. Dynamics uses a threshold to determine a quiet and loud part of both audio tracks. By turning up the dial, first the quiet parts are blended and then it will transition into the loud parts being blended. Invert does the exact opposite once again. Follow is an amplitude shape follower. So this one blends the amplitude shapes of A and B. From 0 to 50 you will hear the sound of A with the amplitude of B, and from 50 to 100% you will hear B with the amplitude of A. Liquid splits the input in 64 spectral bands, and this uses an even and odd band form of a blend. From 0 to 50, the odd bands from A are crossfaded with the odd bands from B. And from 50% and up, the even bands from A will be blended with the even bands from B. Invert does the exact opposite. Multi does something similar, only this one splits the inputs into 6 frequency bands. From 0 to 50, the odd bands are mixed with the odd bands from B, and from 50% and up, the even bands from A will be blended with the even bands from B. Diffuser uses spectral processing to create random variations in each frequency. It applies a sort of a smearing blend effect, and it sounds like this. Wash uses reverb to change the distance between the two tracks, so one track will sound further away and the other one will sound closer. If you use invert, the reverb time will be very short. Blur uses spectral freezing and blurring between the sounds. The invert will result in a much shorter, more artificial sound. Pitch uses pitch shifting to create the blends. The blend will be over 2 octaves or 24 semitones. So turning up the dial will decrease the pitch of A from 0 semitones to minus 24 semitones, while B starts at plus 24 semitones and will decrease to 0 semitones. If you choose invert, these pitches will increase and not decrease. Shift uses frequency shifting for the blend, and it slides up or down by 1 kHz. So by turning up the dial, A will go from 0 to minus 1000 Hz and B will go from 1000 to 0 Hz. And B will start at 1000 and go to 0 Hz. By selecting invert, you will increase these frequencies, not decrease. And the last one is redux. This one uses digital distortion to degrade the audio in a creative way. The blend works like this. A starts clean and B is completely degraded. And by turning up the dial, A gets more and more degraded and B gets more and more clean. Invert changes the sound. Normally it uses rate reduction, and by using invert you will get a sample and hold effect. You could hear this plugin is a little gem when you want something else than standard volume crossfades. With video editing, this plugin can be a godsend for morphing between different sound stages. In sound design, you can create all sorts of interesting morphs between sounds. And in mixing, it's easy to create blends between, for instance, guitar feedback parts. Or even use it to create natural sounding fadeouts on tom-toms. The sky is the limit. Design-wise, this plugin reminds me a hell of a lot of the Parallel Aggressor by Baby Audio. I couldn't find out if they used the same designer for the GUI, but graphical it's very related. That said, you definitely need to check out my Parallel Aggressor review if you're into another great sounding and mix enhancing plugin. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!